Warning, censorship. Warning, censorship.
Speaker, to the Premier, where will these camps be built? How many people will be detained? And for what reasons?
Questions.
For what reasons can people be kept in these isolation camps? And I'd like to have the Premier assure the people of Ontario.
Member, take a seat.
So, Kian, that was Randy Hillier, an elected MPP, trying to get answers. I don't think he got those answers. And, I mean, you brought up the point of CBC. This is not something you're going to see on the CBC. To me, this is a hell of a story. The fact that these camps are going up, we're not 100% sure. It doesn't say so in the fine print nitty-gritty who's destined for these camps. This should be front page news. So why is the mainstream media not gung-ho to report this?
That's a really good question. The mainstream media, when it comes to the term COVID camps, they want to stay well away from that. They want to not touch it with a 10-foot pole, and it's because they're all paid by Justin Trudeau, and Justin Trudeau knows that he botched this file so perfectly. I mean, like, he put out this RFI saying that not only people who that these camps would hold not just people who need to be quarantined for public health reasons, but they would also put people in these camps who meet other government requirements without elaborating on that at all, which is obviously a huge problem. It's not just the coronavirus and public health, it's anything else that Justin Trudeau wants to put you in a camp for. These camps could include that. Now, this camp, I want to reiterate, isn't on a contract right now with Justin Trudeau. But they did tell me that they would take any client who was referred to them, any Canadian, or Manitoban at least, or Métis, who was referred to them by the Manitoba provincial government. They didn't say anything about it being voluntary. They didn't say anything like that. They just said if they were referred to them, their camp would open up their gates. They would roll their gates down and let them in and then close the gates back up. And they would be behind this barbed wire chain link fence, which really was concerning to some folks in the community, according to Portage Online, who said that it drew some ire, because it's just such an ominous looking thing in the middle of the Manitoba prairie. There's this barbed wire camp, and people were rightfully concerned about it because they weren't really sure what was going on there, and they don't know what will go on there. Because if they do secure a contract with the federal government, which is a possibility always, then the local residents are rightfully concerned.
Well, it was a heck of a story, Kian, and who knows? There is such a lack of transparency with this government. It might not even be for COVID-infected individuals to begin with. It might be for enemies of the state. And of course, enemies of the state, through the lens of Justin Trudeau, it's not somebody like Omar Khadr. It's people like you and I and Ezra and Sheila for daring to report this kind of thing. So that's the second facility that your hard work and your persistent digging has found. One last question. Are you off to any other province or region of Canada where there might be another ominous building with barbed wire going up?
That's got to be a secret, David.
Okay, yeah, that's right. Well, I'm sure if there is one, it's going to be you that will find it, Kian, because we can't depend on the bought and paid for members of the mainstream media to possibly embarrass the Prime Minister to such a degree. Hey, folks, you know that we here at Rebel News, we never bend the knee. Whether it's fighting for freedom of speech in the public square or going after politicians behaving badly, but we need your help. Sometimes it's for security costs, sometimes it's for lawyer fees. So if you can, please go to journalistdefensefund.com. That's journalistdefensefund.com. And if you're able to, make a donation. Thank you so much.